over the summer, dividend-paying Caledonia Mining, which owns gold-producing assets in Zimbabwe, published a big increase in production at its 49% owned Blanket mine in the country, and also increased guidance as well from this point on. Vice President of Investor Relations and Corporate Development is Mark Learmonth, and he joins us now with an update. Mark, good to talk to you.
Morning, Jeremy.
Certainly looking at this report, things look very good, and you've also come through, as I say, with this increased guidance.
Yeah, the first quarter for the year was a little bit disappointing in terms of production, and because production was low and our fixed cost base is so high, that translated into some cost per ounce numbers for the first quarter, which we were a little bit disappointed with. That reversed in the second quarter. Second quarter was very strong in production terms, and you know, because we spread the fixed costs over more ounces, it brought our cash costs down again to well below $600 an ounce. We're in the 580s. And for the first time, what we did in the second quarter is we've now adopted the guidance of the World Gold Council in terms of reporting our costs. And even on an all-in sustaining cost basis, we're still well below 1,000 ounces. And we believe that the average all-in sustaining cost of production for most gold miners is about $1,150. So that positions us quite nicely to weather what has become a much more challenging environment for gold producers as the gold price has fallen since April. So we're very pleased. We're not complacent. We have to continue to grow the business, and we're investing to grow the business. So we're not at all complacent, but we've managed to get our production up. We've increased our guidance for the remainder of the year. We were looking at 40,000 ounces for the year. We've now increased that to 44. And that all helps us to continue to invest, to take the business in the direction we want it to go, which is all good news.
And, of course, you've also had this news recently about realignment of members of the board.
Yeah, that's been a process that's been ongoing for about a year. And just to recap what's happened, we've lost three directors, three non-exec directors. Chris Harvey went some time ago. Carl Johnson stepped down as chairman and then more recently retired from the board. And Bob Babenzi also retired from the board a few weeks ago. And then we brought onto the board a new non-exec director, a guy called Johan Holzhausen. And that's a package of movement which really realigns the board so that it's now better positioned to take forward a company that's very different from what it used to be. And just touching on Johan, who's just joined the board, he's a very exciting appointment for us because not only he used to be an audit partner at KPMG in South Africa, and so he's got very, very extensive audit and reporting experience specifically of mining companies, big ones, small ones, good ones, bad ones, across all African jurisdictions, all sorts of commodities. And so he will bring those skills to bear in terms of our reporting and all that sort of stuff. But additionally, he also happens to be a geologist, which means that he can add a lot of value in terms of enhancing the board discussion about exploration projects. And also he's based in South Africa. Which one of the things that we've done as a result of these board changes is to sort of somewhat shift the centre of gravity of the board away from effectively the west coast of North America. It's now more focused on the east coast and South Africa as well, which makes a great deal of sense given the fact that the management team and the assets are all in Africa.
There's also been some speculation about the indigenisation process, hasn't there?
Yes, especially post-elections in Zimbabwe. As far as we know, based on our own experiences at Caledonia, and also from my own position as a member of the executive committee of the Chamber of Mines, there has been no change in the policy of the Zimbabwean government towards indigenisation. They still require that any mining operation of any significant size, 51% of that has to be owned by local people. As far as we know, we're the only previously foreign-owned mining company which has fully complied with this. We're the only one to have actually completed its transactions. They're all legally binding. Now, but what is coming through in this post-election period is the Zimbabwean government is getting increasingly aggressive about insisting that Zimbabweans will not pay for the resources in the ground. Mm-hmm. They believe the resources in the ground belong to Zimbabweans and they will not pay for it. Happily, the way we structured our transaction is that the Zimbabweans were given full credit for the resources in the ground. The reason they then had to stump up an extra $30 million to lift their stake up to 51% was simply because the size of the resources in the ground didn't stretch to giving them a 51% stake in the business.
So what can investors expect from here?
Well, I think they can expect us to continue with our stated strategy of growing the business. We've said we're going to increase production to 76,000 ounces by 2016. We don't need to raise any external finance for that. And notwithstanding the lower gold price, the fact that we've already started to increase our production means that our cash generation is pretty much unaffected, even though the gold price is lower. So we're not impeded in our ability to take this business forwards, unlike so many other gold companies at the moment. So we would expect, as we grow the business, to increase our profitability, and in the ordinary course of events, that will flow through into higher profits and hopefully a higher share price.
Indeed. No, Mark, thanks for joining us. Mark Learmonth there from Caledonia Mining.